Hi, this is Steve Sullivan, Training Supervisor at Rittal Corporation. In this video, we're going to compare two freestanding modular cabinets, the Rittal TS8, and we're going to look at the Hoffman Proline G2. Both of these are modular freestanding cabinets that are available in the market today, and we're going to compare just some tasks that lend itself to use costs of working with each design. And the Rittal TS8, the convention in Europe is a right-hand hinge door, and there's many reasons why somebody may want to remove the door. One, just to make it very easy to work in the cabinet. Another reason might be to put cutouts and holes in the door for your controls like push buttons or HMIs. Later on in this video, we will also look at door reversal. But right now, something as simple as taking off the door with the Rittal TS8 involves four hinge bodies. Now these hinge bodies have captive hinges. They are discrete hinge bodies, so there are four of them as standard on the right hand side. And just by simply taking a flat blade screwdriver and popping the upper hinge pin up and the lower hinge pin down, then I can do this with four hinge bodies and very simply remove the door. This is a one person task and it can be done very easily. One of the most important concerns for our customers obviously is safety. This is achieved through best practices and proper bonding and grounding of electrical enclosures. In the TS8, the standard mounting hardware with its grounding teeth provide this bonding back to the frame. Even in the case of the cable entry plates, each individual plate is grounded back to the enclosure. With the G2, every individual panel, including each cable entry plate, has to have its own ground strap and associated hardware to provide the same protection level as the Rittal TS8. Now, another thing that you may do to gain both usable depth in the enclosure and many times the ability to put more weight on the panel itself is to put the panel in what's called the rearmost position. This would be the furthest most position that the panel could be placed in the cabinet. To do that with the Rittal TS8, once you've removed the panel, you simply take the top brackets that are a toolless clip. So I don't need any tools to do this. I simply use my fingers to undo a clip. I move the top brackets back. The brackets that held the mounting panel in the bottom are no longer needed because the mounting panel feet have a pin in them, and that pin will then insert into the frame of the TS8. So I've really eliminated some additional hardware in the end that I no longer need when I'm positioning the panel in the rearmost position of a TS8. So very quick, very simple to move the panel to the back. One of the things I noticed in real time while watching this video of what we shot in the lab was that with the TS8, I was able to not only move our mounting panel to the rearmost position, but as I was able to install a sidewall with all of its brackets, I was able to install a system chassis and remove half of the door hardware on the TS8 in the time that it took me to simply move the G2 panel to a different position in their enclosure. Reversing the door on both the TS8 from Rittal and the Hoffman Proline G2 are a bit different. As I mentioned, the convention outside of the U.S. is for a right-hand hinged enclosure, while in the U.S., the predominant method is a left-hand hinged enclosure. Both designs afford you the ability to reverse the doors. On the TS8, this task is very simple. You simply have four hinge bodies on one side, four catches on the other side, and literally just switching their position across the frame by use of a T30, that's a Torx fastener. You simply change position across the frame. Reattach the door, and again, this can be a toolless task, just using your fingers to pinch the hinge pins down on the TS8. And then on the front, once I've closed the door, since the lock face is symmetrical, I can simply take the logo and the small acrylic window and change those from the bottom to the top. at the end of the day, I think when we compare and contrast both modular cabinet designs, the TSA is far simpler, far quicker, and easier to work with than the similar cabinet from Hoffman Proline G2. This is going to save you money, save you time, save you resources in working with the cabinet. Now that the doors have been removed from the cabinet, the next task that we're going to look at obviously is another very common task, and that's the removal of the mounting panel. This will be done to obviously populate the enclosure and all the controls and switchgear components on the plate. So in the Rittal TS8, you simply have two bolts at the top that you back out. The mounting panel then slides out on slide rails and you remove the panel.